Well, have you ever had someone you idolized, imitated, and hoped to meet one day? This is video of one of the two movie guys, Lucas Ross, imitating Steve Martin when he was just a teenager. No one is crazier about that wild and crazy guy than Lucas. And this week, Lucas caught up to his holy grail. He met Steve Martin after he performed for the first time in 35 years in Oklahoma. He was in Tulsa. And we're coming to you live now from Lucas's office because what a big event this was. He grabbed me by the throat yesterday, said, look at this picture. And there you were with your idol.
Hey, you know what? It was really awesome. I can't believe it happened. And when I was a kid, I always dreamed of meeting him. I used to write him letters, draw him pictures, and ask him to add it to his art collection. And
this has been an obsession for 20 years.
Yeah, a little bit, a little bit. This is, my wife is really happy that I can finally shut up about this.
And so. You kind of did a little bit of an interview with him.
Yes, I didn't have a whole lot of time, but I did a little bit of editing. I don't think you're probably going to notice any tomfoolery.
I'd like to see it.
Okay.
Let's take a look.
Steve, you've played the banjo everywhere from New York to California. Where's your favorite place you've ever played the banjo? Great.
Okay, so now when you met him yesterday, what did he say to you? You were with him, what, 12 seconds?
Yeah, maybe that. Well, I was trying to work out an interview with him, all these things just didn't happen. It's hard. You know, he's 66.
Security guards got in the way.
Yeah, exactly. He's just having fun. He doesn't need to do all the promotion stuff. But luckily, I finagled a deal, and in a second, I had a moment to meet him. And we got a picture, and we talked about how he's responded to a few of my tweets here and there. I tweet him like every day about six times.
And look at all the stuff you've got. This is how old?
Well, this is a ticket stub from the last time he was here. This is 35 years ago. Hugh Hale, a friend of mine, gave me this. He said, you're a bigger fan than I am. I want you to have it.
How nice.
And this is the first thing he talked about when he did his concert the other night. He said, it's been 35 years since I've been here.
So he remembered that.
And I had this in my wallet and I almost gave it to him, but then I kept it.
Yeah, well, why not? And his albums?
His record. A friend of mine, Felix Matos, who's a local painter, he painted that for me one time, surprised me on my birthday. And this is his first book. I have a first edition copy, and he signed it for me the other night, so I got his little...
That's nice.
Yeah, he was very gracious and really cool.
And I guess the moral of the story is if you have a dream, keep pursuing it, even if it takes 20 years and people think you're a nut.
Yeah, that's a great way to say it.
Mom, I didn't mean that about him.
Hey, well, you know what? He's not the only person I've been a big fan of my whole life.
Oh, yeah?
That's absolutely you.
Oh.
I have a whole shrine of Linda right over here. I've got some pictures right here.
Yeah,
I'm a huge fan of Linda.
I don't really think there's any comparison, but I do appreciate
you
being in the same room with him, although this room is a little odd, Lucas, I've got to admit.
it was an interesting dressing room at one time. But
I'm glad that you got your dream reached, and we're happy for you.
Hey, thank you, Linda. That was cool.
And we'll be back after this.